All right. Which scatter plot shows the relationship between x and y if x represents a student's score on a test and y represents the number of incorrect answers? So the more answers you get incorrect, the lower your score. So the incorrect answers here on test scores don't really make sense because this is saying the more incorrect answers, the higher your test score. That's not usually going to happen. Here, it doesn't really seem to matter, right? There's no real line of best fit here. Maybe it's kind of here the line of best fit. That kind of implies that it doesn't really matter how many things you get wrong. Your test score can still increase, right? Because as you go further on the x-axis, your test scores are increasing. The fourth choice doesn't make sense as well. This is saying that no matter how many incorrect answers you have and go up on the y-axis, your test score is always the same. Whatever your test score is, it's always this one number. So the only thing left is this choice right here, and that makes the most sense because, right, your test scores are going to do what? Well, as the number of incorrect answers is increasing, as the number of incorrect answers is decreasing, the test score is increasing, right? This is a low test score right here with a really high amount of incorrect answers. Jump on this side, this is a really high test score with a really low amount of answers. And the trend is, you know, this is going down here. That means, yeah, your test scores are going up along the x-axis as your height is going down, as your number of incorrect answers are going down. So that one is the answer.